In this video, I am going to explain you from 9th standard NCERT exercise 4.3 in that 8th question. So this is one of the important question from this exercise, but it's easy. So let us start with the question. In countries like USA and Canada, temperature is measured in Fahrenheit, whereas in country like India, we measure the temperature in Celsius. Here, a linear equation that converts Fahrenheit to Celsius is given. So the temperature will be same, but the way of measuring is different. So how to convert the temperature in Fahrenheit into Celsius? Here it is given in terms of linear equation. Suppose you want to convert the temperature from Celsius to the Fahrenheit, that can be also done. So what is the question? Draw the graph of linear equation above using the Celsius for x-axis. So on x-axis you have to show the Celsius and Fahrenheit for the y-axis. So the ready-made equation is given. Just you have to find, or you have to put the three values of Celsius and respective values of Fahrenheit here to calculate. Then we will go for second, third, fourth and fifth question. So first we will find out three values of Celsius and three values of Fahrenheit. So this is the equation given. So we can put any Celsius here. 1 Celsius and Celsius can be, temperature can be negatives. But to do the calculation easily, what we'll do? Here you can see in the denominator we have the 5. So here we can divide this denominator with any numerator, with 9 or with C. But 9 we cannot divide, so with C we can divide. So try to put C as a multiples of 5. So that no need to do more calculation. 5, so it will completely divide. So what I'll do here? C and here F. C, as it is told, we have to show, we have to take Celsius on x-axis and Fahrenheit on y-axis. When I'll put C as 0, you can put 0 also if you want, because temperature can be 0. But I will take here other than zeros. So at least 3 you have to calculate. So when Celsius is 5, so let us take here, what will happen? 9 upon 5 into C is 5 plus 32. 5 ones are 5, 5 ones are 5. So F is 9 plus 32. So F is 9 plus 32 is 41. So this is 41 Fahrenheit. When temperature is 5 degrees Celsius in Fahrenheit, it will be measured as 41. Next, I'll put C as 10. So C, F equals to 9 by 5 into C is 10 plus 32. 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 32. So 9 twos are 18 plus 32. 8 plus 2 is 10, carry 1, 1, 2 and here 5. So when temperature is 10 degrees Celsius in Fahrenheit, it will be 50 Fahrenheit. Now third value will find out here. So now I'm going to put Celsius as 15. 9 by 5 into C is 15 plus 32. 5 ones are 5, 5 threes are 9, threes are 27 plus 32. 7 plus 2 is 9, 3 plus 2 is 59. So we got here 59 Fahrenheit. So let us draw the graph for this, because our first question is draw the graph of linear equation above using Celsius for x and Fahrenheit for y axis. So first we'll draw the graph and then we'll go for remaining questions. So as you can see, we have not taken any temperature as a negative temperature. So we want more positive x-axis coordinate and positive y-axis coordinate. So the highest in x coordinate is 15 and the highest in y is 59. So till 15 you have to show. But if you show 1 centimeter equals to 1, it will not fit in a graph. So we can take the equal interval. So what we'll do, 59, so till at least 6 you want, otherwise you can take 2, 2. If you take 2 units, what happens? 59, that's 60, 30 units you need. But that is not possible. So what we'll do, we'll take 1 unit, that is 1 centimeter equals to 10 degrees Celsius on x-axis. And here also we'll take same only. 1 unit or 1 centimeter equals to 10 Fahrenheit. Thank you. So here on x axis we have to take Celsius. This is Celsius. This will be what? Negative Celsius. And here we are going to show the Fahrenheit. So the scale, it is very important to take scale. On both the axis. If you have large graph paper, you can show the enlarged graph. That is, you can take 1 centimeter equals to 1 Fahrenheit, 1 Celsius like that. Otherwise, 1 centimeter equals to 2 Celsius and 2 Fahrenheit you can show. But I will take here. 1 unit means what? 1 centimeter equals to 10 Celsius here and 1 unit equals to 10 Fahrenheit. Or if you want, you can take 5 also. 30, 40 and so on. We need till 15. On y axis, we need till 60. So 10, 20, 30, 40. 50, 60, one extra I am showing here. So these are in Fahrenheit, these are in centigrade. So what we'll do? We'll start showing the points here. When Celsius is 5, when you have the 5 degrees Celsius temperature, the same temperature will write in Fahrenheit as 41. So 5 and 41 you have to join. So there are 10 lines between 0 to 10. So the fifth one, the middle one will be 5. And 41 here, we have to show immediately after 40, we will have the 41. So, this is 5 and 41 we will have here. So, go till here and it is 41. From here, 41 is coming here. So, here this is 5 and 41. Next one, 10 and 15. When this is 10, Fahrenheit is 50. When Celsius is 10, Fahrenheit is 50. So 10 and 15. Next, when it is 15, x is 15. Means what? Celsius is 15, Fahrenheit is 59. 15 will come here and 59 just before the 60. So this is x is 15, y is 59. Now join these three points. These three points must lie on the same line. Then only you can see that your calculation is correct. So you can see these three points lies on the same line. Okay. So you can extend if you want. You can extend this. So how much you want you can extend. But at least these three points you have to join. So this is the first part of the question is over. Now if the temperature is 30 degree, what is the temperature in Fahrenheit? So now first question is over. The second is if the temperature is 30 degrees Celsius. So earlier we had taken our own values for Celsius. Now they are given if the temperature is 30 degrees Celsius, what is the temperature in Fahrenheit? So we will put here 30 and we will find out the respective Fahrenheit temperature. So this is second question. When C is 30 degrees Celsius, what is Fahrenheit it is asked? So same, this is the equation, or you can say this is a formula to find out the temperature in Fahrenheit Celsius. 9 divided by 5. Celsius is 30 plus now here 32. So 5 ones are 5, 5 6 are 30. F equals to 9 into 6 plus 32. F equals to 9 6 are 6 9 are you can find out. This is 54 plus 32. So F is 86. So you got here F as 80 Fahrenheit. So this is the answer for the second question. When temperature is 30 degree, the same temperature will measure in Fahrenheit as 86 Fahrenheit. Now the third one here is, if the temperature is 95 Fahrenheit, what is the temperature in Celsius? So when Fahrenheit it is given 95 Fahrenheit, what is a Celsius? So same equation we are going to take, 9 by 5. Here into C plus 32. So Fahrenheit value we know. So we will put 95 equals to 9 by 5 into C plus 32. So we will solve this simple equation. So 95. Shift this minus this 30 to that side. It will be minus 32. Why we have to shift this 32 instead of these all things? See, we have to keep one side, and these 95 and 32 we have to same. But this is a different term only, because it is separated by plus or minus sign. Then it is different term. So different term we have to send first, and then the 9 and 5. Minus 32 equals to 9 by 5 into C. So 95 minus 32. 5 minus 2 is 3. 9 minus 3 is 6. Equals to 9 by 5 into C. So now we will find out the value of C. C will keep one side. 63 divided by 5 will be multiplied by 5. And here multiply by 9 will be divided by this. So 9 ones are 9. 9 sevens are 63. So 7 into 5 divided by 1. Divided by 1 will be as it is. So 7 5 is 35. So as it is Celsius. So we will find out this as 35 degrees Celsius. So this is the answer. Temperature is 95 degrees Celsius, will measure the same temperature in Celsius as 35 degrees Celsius. Now we'll move for the fourth question. So the fourth question is, if the temperature is 0 degrees Celsius, so Celsius they are given 0 degrees Celsius, what is the temperature in Fahrenheit? So what is the temperature in Fahrenheit? And if the temperature is 0 Fahrenheit, so two questions are there. If temperature is 0 Fahrenheit, then what is the temperature in Celsius? So what is the temperature in Celsius? So same equation we are going to take. It is like formula. When Celsius is 0 degree Celsius into 0 plus 32. So into 0 means this full term will be 0. So F will get was 32 Fahrenheit. So here the temperature is 32 Fahrenheit when our temperature is 0 degree Celsius. In same question, one more sub question is there. When temperature is 0 Fahrenheit, what is the Celsius? So take same formula or same equation, put F as 0, 9 by 5, C equals plus 32. So we have to find out the value of C. So send this 32 to that side. It will be minus 32. 0 minus 32 is minus 32. Shift this 5 and 9 that side. Now here it is divided by 5. When it will shift that side, it will be multiplied by 5. This is 9 into C, it will be divided. So here we cannot divide completely. So 32 into 5. So if we do 32 into 5, we will get minus 160 divided by 9. And definitely you will get the answer in decimals. So you will get answer in decimals as minus 17.8 degrees Celsius. So when Fahrenheit is 0, Celsius will be minus 17.8 degrees Celsius. Now the fifth question. In fifth question it is asked, is there temperature which is numerical? Means what? If we ignore the units, only numbers if you observe, numerical is the same, equal in both Fahrenheit and Celsius. If S, find it. So we'll find out this. At what temperature, at what value, both numericals will be equal? Means what? In Fahrenheit also 40, in Celsius also 40, but unit will be different. So we'll take the same equation, F equals to 9 by 5. Into C plus 32. It is said when it will be equal. So we will make both Fahrenheit and Celsius equal. You can write this as Celsius or you can write this as Fahrenheit. So I would like to take this as both are equal here. When these two will be equal, at what temperature we are going to find out. So C I will write here 9 by 5 into C plus 32. Solve this equation. So this is fraction, we'll find out for fractional part. 9 by 5, 9 into C is 9C, then 5 into 32, so we can find out LCM or you can do the cross multiplication. 5 into 32, so 32 into 5 or 5 into 32 you can do, whole divided by 5. Now this 5 will shift this side, so it is 5C, this is 9C, plus this is 32 into 5. That is 5 to the 10, that is 160 you will get here. So this 5 I shifted there. So 5 into C is 5C. Now easily we can calculate the values. So 160 I will shift this side and 5C I will bring this side. Because all C we should get on the same side. So minus 160. And here 9C minus 5C. Because I want C as a positive. So 160 here and 9c minus 5c is 4c. We want to find out c. So 160 divided by 4. 4 4s are 16. 4 1s are 4. So c. At what temperature both F and c will be equal? At 40 degree, or at you can say minus 40. At this temperature both will be same. Both will show the same numerical value. You can put here. If you put here 40, when Fahrenheit is 40, definitely if you calculate, you will get C as 40 only. Otherwise, if you put here C as 40, even Fahrenheit will get as 40. So, this is how you have to solve this example. So, it is very easy. Just ready-made equations given. Go on putting the value of C and F.